Welcome back to the cabin. It is early November and winter has definitely set in. We have freezing rivers and lakes. We've got a little bit of snow and it has already been below zero several times. We have a very exciting announcement to make. We are going to be offering a calendar for next year, 2021. This is something Eric and I have worked really hard on for over a year, and we have been living in Alaska for a little bit over 2 years, as you may know. During our time here, I think we have both been just really blown away with what we've been able to experience and see, so much more than we ever imagined when we moved here. So we thought it would be awesome to share some of these photos with you guys, and you can have Alaska at home with you. Both of us really appreciate the support we've had from our viewers throughout this time that we've lived here. And if you guys are at all interested in getting a calendar, we are going to leave all the information in the description below. With that being said, this video is not all about our calendar, and we are going to be going over some fun stuff. We get lots of questions on where we keep our food, and specifically, where are we keeping our food this year without the root cellar? Even though that was a loss that we did not foresee, we have moved on and figured out how to store our food for this winter. We're gonna be taking you around all of our kitchen today and even taking you outside and showing you some of our other food storage. First, we're gonna head to our canned food shelf because that is the most exciting thing with almost all of the canned food that we have canned this year. This is our shelf where we're storing most of our canned food, and Eric built this earlier this year with predominantly wood we had lying around, and it's really awesome. I really, really like it. It's not completely functional for like permanent use, just the way that the cans are layered on top of each other, and also the fact that it occupies quite a bit of space in our small cabin. It doesn't always look this beautiful behind me. I went through this yesterday and organized it. We've actually been pulling a lot of this canned food, already starting to eat through it, and I did kind of like a rough count of all our jars, and we're sitting a little bit below 450. They're not all sitting here. We have them in other parts of the house, but this holds quite a bit. I think it holds in the 300 range. We're gonna go ahead and jump in with what we have in here, what we can this year. I know that is what you guys are interested in. So I'm gonna start on our top row. First thing I have in this corner is some spruce tip syrup. So this is something I'm super excited about this year. We generally do not buy syrup. It's just one of those things we kind of cut out, but we love syrup. So surprisingly, this actually turned out really well. It does use quite a bit of sugar, but you use spruce tips that you collect in June around here in our area, and it makes like an awesome syrup, and we use that on pancakes. We've got a whole bunch of coleslaws that we can. This is our purple variety, and I kept it like that so it didn't dye the green variety. I have two different kinds of those. And moving on to salmon. We have silver salmon. I believe this is smoked and seasoned by Eric. Way back in here, I have some canned greens, and these are from last year. We had very little carryover, I'm gonna call it, from last canning season to this year. I think it was somewhere like 80 jars we had probably the beginning of summer, I'll say, and we've definitely eaten through a lot more of those. So at this point, I think we only have like 25 jars from last year. We found out we did not really like greens that way, so we froze the mass majority of our greens this year. We've got some mustard here. This is a spicy mustard that we make. I only have to make this twice a year. It's awesome. We love having it like that. That's a condiment that is a major staple for us. I have a jar of rosehip highbush cranberry syrup, and then I also have some elderberry syrup. This is also from last year after living here for a few years and kind of testing, you know, the different berries and in recipes. We have ways that are our favorites now, and we've kind of been able to tell, you know, what they really work well for. And so in my opinion, rose hips are a lot like tomatoes. I know that sounds weird, but I like to use them for like a barbecue sauce or ketchup. That works really well for us. In fact, I don't really like them for syrups because they just tend to taste more like a tomato. And the highbush cranberries, those are super tart. And same thing with the elderberry. It's kind of got like a fermented flavor. So not really my idea of like a sweet syrup. So I tend to use those for different things now. Moving on to our favorite, cowboy candy and cowboy candy marinade. Need to grow a lot more of these peppers next year. This is rosehip ketchup, and this is one of my absolute favorites. First time trying this year, and this is really good with chili. We have yet to try it on meatloaf, but we want to try it that way too. As far as our jellies go, I don't have that many. Eric and I were so busy this year that we just
didn't really pick that many berries, which sucks because I don't have that many jellies or jams, but I do have some. We made a blueberry and fireweed jelly, really, really super delicious. This one sat really nicely. And then we also made spruce jelly and rosehip jelly, so that one's really good too. And that's it as far as the jellies go. Eric's not a huge fan of them. I do like them, but we just don't go through them that fast. I mean, I think for us, if we're not buying syrup, it's a good thing for like pancakes or a good thing for oatmeal, something like that. It's also really nice like on sourdough at night in the middle of winter when you're looking for something to eat. Moving on down to the other row of salmon, we have some sockeye salmon or red salmon. This is just smoked, there's no seasoning on it. And then we move over to our pink salmon and that's seasoned and smoked. Altogether this year, I think we have like 80 to 90 jars of salmon, less than we've had in the years past, but it's a really good amount for us, especially with the mousse. And we've already been, you know, flying through these. A lot of the times once we can something, if we can something in June, we may turn around and take it on a trip in July. So these jars are not for only winter eating. One thing to note is that the salmons have different textures and different flavors. The red salmon, definitely fresh. That's my absolute favorite. It has more oil in it and it's a more flavorful fish. It's a little bit drier too. And the pink salmon is a little more mushy. So we really like to use pink salmon for salmon patties. That's one of our favorite things to make in the winter. Next, we have a whole bunch of carrots. We canned a lot of our carrots this year because not having the root cellar, I anticipated that we would really have no way to store them. I have a few in a 5-gallon bucket, but I just didn't think that those are realistically gonna last more than a month or two. So we canned them all, and it's really good to add into soups, but it's not my favorite way. I would rather have a fresh, cold, crisp carrot in the middle of winter. So we have lots of carrots, and in fact, some of them are even from last year. We canned a few of the smaller ones, and we didn't actually go through all of them. Down here, we have our turnip and kohlrabi relish. That's really good. That had cumin in it. We tried it the other day. I really like that one. We have some honey and lemon turnips. Turnips was a really good year for us. So there's a lot of turnips and kohlrabi in these jarred foods. I got some more canned greens and we have zucchini relish. We have some green onions, carrots, and green beans from last year. Just a few jars of those. A whole bunch of pickled veggies that we did earlier this year. We tried to stay away from a lot of the pickled foods because that can get pretty old pretty fast. In fact, this year we have no pickles, which is just absolutely mad. But we've been canning for years and we have always made pickles, and it's just always one of those things we have leftovers of. Cucumbers didn't do that well this year, so that was actually really fine with us. More carrots. We have our banana peppers. We call them pepperoncinis, but these are our banana peppers that we grew and pickled. And then I have a bunch of sauerkraut. You may notice lots of the things that we jar, we choose pint size, and that is just like over the years we've kind of figured out what we eat when we go to open it and how much of it we eat, if that makes any sense. So salsa is one thing that we do go through a lot of, and this is our green salsa. We roasted it this year and used onions and a whole bunch of other stuff, and it turned out awesome. I'd really like to grow and have more production from our tomatillos next year. Although we had not a great summer this year, wasn't that hot, we did get a lot of tomatoes, so that was awesome. We got a lot of tomato sauce. I'm very happy with that. That's just normal tomato sauce, got some herbs. We don't have any sugar in that. I have our green coleslaw down here, carrots, kohlrabi, a whole bunch of other stuff. And we have a lot of tallow. We got a lot of tallow off that mousse, which is awesome. It's beautiful, beautiful, like clean white color. Never seen anything so beautiful as that. We really like lard, but because we harvested a mousse this year, it was just more practical to use the fat from the mousse rather than have to go purchase some from a pig. This is some beef tallow that we also have. We picked this up from a butcher when we had a pig butchered last year, and you can see it kind of has like a yellow tint. I believe that's just because of the diet that the animal had. Now on to my favorite row. It's just because it's a lot of things in quarts, which always really feels good when you get a quart of food. We actually just did this. This is our celery stock, and it's just kind of like a soup base. You just add it to soup. You can definitely add some cream to it. It has carrots and onions in it this year. Next, we can't see it, but we have fish stock and chicken stock. We have chicken stock from earlier this year when we processed the roosters. And then we move back into moose bone broth. And we have a lot of moose bone broth from the one we got earlier in the year. And it turned out absolutely awesome. It's actually got quite a bit of a thick layer of fat on it. It's this gorgeous golden color. We love stocks and broths around here. That's like our main thing when we're going to cook soup or we're going to cook something, you know, even if it's rice or beans, we like to have something more flavorful. So we have a lot of those things and we're always kind of constantly trying to make more of those. This year we made a lot of it because of how our season was and because we didn't have the root cellar. So that always influences what we're making, how much we're making it, how we're preserving it. We can a lot, so we like to just try different recipes. Not all of these are ones that we do every single year, and we've just experimented and seen which ones we liked, and again, went with what did well that season. Last year when we did the root cellar tour, I believe we had 550 jars. And so the way that works with us is it's like, it's just constantly evolving. There's no way for me to get a count and be like, yes, we put up 600 jars this year. If I had to estimate, it would be probably 600 jars a year, give or take a little bit more or less, depending upon the year, if that makes any sense. But it just depends on that year, what's practical for us. We have a really small solar system, so dehydrating is really not an option unless we want to run our generator. In fact, we used it so little since we moved here that we sold it, so we don't even have a dehydrator anymore. We do have a freezer, so we have that means of storing things, but with the moose and some of the other produce we have in there, and especially for our dogs, the diet we feed them, it does get filled up pretty quickly. In an ideal world, we would be eating fresh produce year-round. Eric and I love vegetables and we really like gardening. So moving here, we've really had to adapt to changing our diet and changing how much we preserve. We preserve a lot of our food. I mean, we're growing it in a really short time frame and harvesting it in the wild and then canning it and preserving it and putting it away. I think it brings us great joy to pop open a can of food and know all the ingredients that are in them, but we both would love the option to have fresh vegetables in winter too, especially of our own kinds. That's why the root cellar was really, really awesome for us, because we could have some of those things fresh, and that's just not realistic for us this year. We did have to can a lot more of the produce. The other reason why the amount of jars that we can, you know, constantly changes is because, like I was saying, we eat through them too. So they're not like just a storage for us. They're actually like food. Those are our snack foods. So when we're like, I'm hungry, we have to go open up a few of these cans and make a meal. And that's just the way our life is. We definitely do buy some foods from the store and we do eat out on occasion, but this is really the main food that we're eating. And on that note, we do have a canning season. I mean, it starts probably about midsummer and it carries on till fall, basically. But we pretty much can throughout the year. So it just depends on when we get our hands on something. Sometimes I'll can in June or in the winter months if we get something, and it's not just like a condensed season. Let's head over to our kitchen table and we're gonna show you guys the rest of the canned food that we have. This is the movable stainless steel table that we have in our kitchen. We added another shelf because we just felt like it was perfect to have that here. We don't really utilize the space that well. And we have almost all potato leek soup up here without the cream. We're actually gonna be making that a little bit later today. And we have some more celery stalk. I've got some extra carrots. And then we also have some tomato sauce. While we're on the table, I will show you guys what we have under here. This is flour. We decided to keep flour in a 5-gallon bucket because we go through it so much and so fast in the winter. We're like constantly making sourdough bread. These are the parsnips and the beets that we put in here not that long ago. It's working out fair. I mean, they've only been in here for a few weeks and you can see they're already trying to regrow. They do feel really good, a hair dry, but just so you know, it will work for a little while, and everything about our, you know, element in here is totally off of what you want. It's not dark, it is dry, and it is also very warm. And the carrots are actually doing a lot better. I've had them in here for about a month, and we pulled them out and we're pretty excited about them. They're really, really firm still. They are, you know, trying to grow, but I mean, they look really good. So I think we should be able to get through these in the next month or so. If we had a root cellar or a basement or something like that, this would really all be ideal to stay in there where it's cold, wet, and humid. But we don't, since we lost that guy this year. So we're just working with what we got, and we figured out something pretty nifty for our potatoes. So as you can tell, we have a kitchen countertop and some cabinetry down here. However, both these cabinets kind of ended right here. We had this very valuable space in the back corner. So Eric decided to take his sawzall and cut us a little hole back here that we actually have a bunch of our potatoes in. So as you can tell, we have lots of our little potatoes right up front. I'm trying to go through those first. And then in the back, we have a lot of the bigger potatoes. And we were able to give a lot of those away this year. So I think this is probably a few months worth for us. And I think they'll go till February, just honestly, in my opinion. I do not think they would make it until May when we need to plant them again. So we're probably gonna be buying seed potatoes. And I have a towel right here to block out the light. That is the single most important thing with potatoes. They can't have light ever or they will start to sprout. It also keeps it pretty cold in there and the humidity is slightly higher. We put a temperature gauge in there and it's about 45% humidity, I believe, and we were keeping it in about 50 degrees temperature. So that's fair. That's not ideal, but you know, it's better than our cabin. Directly above us is where I would normally store my eggs, but I have 35 chickens and I only have one egg. So our chickens have been molting and just not laying. And we do get questions about that. How do we store extra eggs? I don't, because I don't have any extra eggs. We would go through probably a dozen in a day with our dogs and us, and we're just not getting that right now, as you can tell. So if I had my choice, I would pickle them. We want to have lots of pickled eggs in the future. We've got some wheat flour on our counter, and then we got this really cool hanging basket, just trying to utilize the space again that we have. These are more potatoes. We've got little onions in there and some garlic up top, and we have these really beautiful onions decorating the wall on the back. This is where we keep our spices. I keep our sourdough starter and our kefir greens. And we also have this little herb mixture that I made up. We like to save all our herbs, and I found that we use them a lot more if they're already all like blended together. We can just sprinkle them on each meal. We have a little storage next to the oven that I will show you guys. Got lots of bands and lids for our canning jars as we're taking them off. Just some extra pots. A few of our winter squash, we did not do well on those at all this year. This is some of our extra garlic. We have coffee, some more flour, some sugar. We have some apple cider vinegar that we made last year, and olive oil, our water, and of course our little setup for our house. And lastly, we're gonna talk about what we have on our shelves, which is also dry storage. The top two shelves is where most of our food is at. I have lots of the herbs up top that we saved. And we just grind those up if we're looking for like one herb specifically, or if we want coriander or something like that. And then we have some more grains, peas, lentils, quinoa, beans, rice, all that kind of stuff on that second shelf and first shelf. And then we also have all of our tea mixtures. And I have found that I like to just do blends. I was at first kind of separating everything. This is just rose petals. But now what I do is I'll collect all the things and make like a mixture, because to me, the overall result is much better. You get like a real nice blended mixture for tea. And this is like our baking section. Eric and I are not bakers, but we do like to do a lot of it when it gets to winter and it's dark and everyone wants to make dessert. So there is a big baking section here. And this is our coffee station. And I'm gonna be turning the camera around to Eric. He has a lot more to show you guys.
Before we get to the refrigerator tour, we missed a couple of our canned foods. These are purple carrots and they're from last year. And the reason they're from last year is they're not that good. So we don't eat them very often. So we got a few of those left. And then we have a jelly that Arielle made and it didn't set correctly. So she's gonna reprocess these. Let's jump over to the refrigerator. And when I mean refrigerator, I mean ice chest. We don't have a refrigerator. We do have a freezer that stays outside. All I do in the summertime is I will freeze 1 gallon jugs of water in the freezer and I'll just swap them out in here and this thing stays nice and cold. Since it's wintertime, all I have to do is take our ice jug and I put it on the front porch and I just swap them out. Let's take a look at what is in here. Since we eat so much canned food and just meat, we don't really keep a lot in our refrigerator. Like I said, we have our gallon jug. We do have a gallon of milk. And we get really excited for this milk. This is actually from a local farm, so this is really good milk. We use this in our coffee and just to drink. We have a moose roast that we're gonna be using for dinner a little later on. And then we just have some random canned foods. We've got some jelly that we opened up. We've got some of our mustard. We've got some kefir. And we've got some yeast that we use every once in a while for making bread. And then we have our little cat's can of cat food. This is my Asian section. I have soy sauce, ginger, and wasabi because I've been on an Asian kick lately, making lots of sushi. That's it for the fridge. I think we're gonna head outside. We're gonna check out the freezer. We're out here in the Shelter Logic. This is our freezer. It's winter here in Alaska, not technically, but here it is, and it's freezing temperature, so the freezer has been off for quite a while, so we don't have to run it in the winter time. That being said, we don't have a light in there, so I'm gonna use the flashlight, and we're just gonna dive in and see what's in here. As you know, we processed a moose this year. We ended up with 278 pounds of moose meat, so most of what's in here is moose meat. We don't really have a lot of dog food right now. We do have a little bit of organ meat in there for them, and then we have some pork bones down in there that we are gonna be making soup out of. Up top in the vacuum packing bags, these are just our moose roasts. And these little bags, these are either our sausage or our ground moose meat. And then a few bags down on the bottom, we keep the good stuff. And what I mean by the good stuff, that's either backstrap steaks, tenderloin, or some really nice steaks that we cut out of the roast meat. Pretty much the rest of the stuff in here is going to be veggies. We have leeks, cauliflower. I mean, we've got Brussels sprouts, a bunch of kale, some onions. We've got a lot of bell peppers this year. Those are really good when we're making soup. That's pretty much it for out here. And this thing, looking in and out, this thing was actually pretty full not too long ago. So we've made quite a big dent in it. The last of our food storage is actually in our conex. So let's head out there. Okay, so out here, we basically just keep stuff out here that can get frozen. So we have just random stuff in here. We have a thing of peanut butter. We bought this a really long time ago. Turns out we don't really eat that much peanut butter. We have some molasses, some mustard seed, and the powder that Arielle made the mustard out of. We've got a couple spare things of coffee. We really like to drink coffee, especially in the winter. We probably do 2 cups a day. In the back, we have a few extra vinegars. Actually, we have just two. We have a regular and an apple cider. We got an extra thing of salt. We have a big 50-pound sack of flour. We actually get that at Costco. It seems to be the best bang for our buck, and it's actually pretty decent flour. This year, we bought a 25-pound bag of white rice. Also, we have some nuts. We have some extra yeast. We have a big bag of celery seeds, which is awesome to have. Chocolate powder, quinoa, extra coconut oil. We like to use coconut oil in baking because we don't usually buy butter, and we have an extra olive oil. We are not quite done yet. We have a little more dry storage in the back. Over here are some of our last dry storage that we have. We have just random things in here. Again, stuff that can be frozen. We have herbs, we have birch chaga, we have some teas, we have a bunch of chamomile. This stuff is awesome if you want to fall asleep at night. We also have some birch polypore, some more tea mixtures down here, and then one of my prized possessions, my favorite things this year, is all the mushrooms we did. So that's chanterelle mushrooms. And then we have a few more of those, and then those are the morel mushrooms. I've probably mentioned it before, but the chanterelles are definitely my favorite mushrooms. Pretty much put these things in everything, so we're really glad to have these this year. We clearly have a lot of mason jars or canning jars, and most of these we brought with us from Oregon. We have bought just a little bit of them when we were here. So this is kind of where we keep cases that we haven't gotten into, and over on this side, we have cases that we haven't gotten into, and when we have just our used jars, when we use them in the house, we used to put them down in the root cellar and it was perfect, it worked out great, but now we have to bring them over here. So I've kind of organized our shelves, and yeah, this is where we're going to be storing our empty jars this year. I believe it is about 20 degrees outside right now. It's really warmed up. We've been hovering, you know, below 10 for quite a while now, but anyways, we have a snowstorm coming in. We're gonna chop a bunch of kindling, get prepared. We're gonna go inside because I think the fire went out. Light a fire, and we're gonna make some potato leek soup and some moose meat for dinner.
Now that our fire's going, we are going to start dinner. We're going to get some rolls in this Dutch oven and put them on the wood stove. And they're just some yeast rolls, and I use some milk in them. And then we're also going to get our soup cooking as well. So we've already tried this soup. It's awesome. Super simple. Really glad we put the chicken broth in there. We're gonna get all of that in there, and then we're gonna add probably about 1 to 2 cups of water to the soup. And we're gonna get this on the wood stove too.
We're gonna take our potato leek soup and we're gonna kick it up a notch. We're gonna take this moose roast, I'm gonna dice it up into little chunks, and I'm gonna fry it in some moose fat, and when that soup's almost done, we're gonna add it in there.
Our soup has heated up and it's ready to be blended. And the way I like to do it is just blend part of it or most of it. What I do is take a measuring cup and just pull out some of the chunks and some of the liquid, and we're gonna leave part of it chunky. I'm gonna add back in the soup and the potatoes and carrots and all the onions and good stuff. That's the consistency I wanted, so we're gonna add in some of that meat, and then we're gonna put it back on the stove, and when the bread's done, we're gonna be adding some milk to this soup.
Well, the soup's been done for a while, it's nice and hot. The bread took a while, but it's finally done. We're gonna add our cream. In this case, it's just gonna be whole milk. We're gonna add it to our soup, and we're gonna be ready to eat. Dinner is served and it's looking good. I'm gonna top mine with some sauerkraut. You want some on yours?
Yes.
And that's kind of the thing with eating the way we do and eating a lot of canned food is you definitely have to get creative. We make a lot of weird things. Most of the time they work out, I like to say, but sometimes they don't. But you gotta get creative with canned food.
Most of how we eat has stemmed from frugality, believe it or not, and we also really love vegetables and growing our own food and, you know, just going out in there and getting it. And that, honestly, when you have food like that, when you've worked so hard for it, you appreciate it so much and you really are inspired to make meals like this. And so, to me, it's just awesome. We have awesome ingredients and it makes wonderful meals. And of course, you do too.
Well, I think that's gonna do it for today. Thank you guys for watching. We're gonna eat. We'll see you next time.
You slurp your soup much?
Mm-hmm.
That is not that hot. That is really weird. We put a little temperature gauge in there and it's... That's just lovely. Ah.
Okay, go ahead.
Whoa. That's a jalapeno. Sorry. Okay. Just looks super funny. She's so scared.
She's okay. Changed.
You can get down. You can get down. I know she's changed, babe. She's an adult kitten. Oh yeah, that's all.
Heavy? Yeah! I got it. Don't whoop her. She's gonna do something bad.
Pepper!
Yeah, she's getting freaky. Struggle is real.